I did something that displeased him, and he grabbed me. My arm is still marked from where he grabbed me.
He assaulted me. He smashed the glass vase into my forehead and split my head open.
And I can just remember when he left me on the floor and he thought I was dead. He just thought he had killed me.
I had to be the father figure in my brother and sister's life because my dad isn't there for us. And I had to take care of my grandfather too because he's legally blind. And I have to get a job to help out around the house, and it's just hard to go to school and come home and help your brother and sister with their homework and cook and clean and then deal with your own stuff. It's just a lot.
Sometimes you need to reach up, and sometimes when you reach up, there's not always something that reaches back. You have nothing to talk to or nothing that talks back. You feel alone, and you start asking questions, and you start feeling like you're so alone that I had this numbness inside of me.
I had a call down on 23rd Street where the husband came, and he's kicking in the door, and she's on the phone, and she's screaming, "He's coming in, I can't stop him, he's coming in. And what am I supposed to do?" And you can just hear she's just losing it. And he comes in and he killed her. He stabbed her to death while we're sitting there listening on the phone. I mean, it's just, you feel helpless.
No matter what you went through, you can always turn it around and always be grateful for what you do have. And with this new house and everything.
Being able to live here, call it my home, and I like the TV. I never had a TV like this. So.
To see them in an environment that they're comfortable and safe, and to see them relaxed, I think was the biggest, you know, joy.
Some people don't get to be safe. Some people don't get to sleep, and some people don't get to eat.
A lot of the women are afraid, first and foremost, about their children. Prior to their own safety, they're always asking about their options for their kids.
If I can show them that a different reality exists besides the one that they've known and been born into, it's amazing.
I am very privileged to be at a place where we can even offer the most basic things to somebody who doesn't get them.
If you find something in life that you're real passionate about and for, follow it by all means. And for me, myself, Rose Brooks, this is the place to be.
If you don't love yourself and you don't take care of yourself first, you can't love your children and you can't do what you need to do for them.
It takes a lot of strength, and I think the encouragement that I got from Rose Brooks to break the cycle that I was caught in. And to be out of that is a blessing, and I thank Rose Brooks.
One day a light just came on, and I realized I was worth the work and worth the time. I'm so peaceful. It is such a joy to come in my door at night and know that this is our home. No one is going to hurt my children or hurt me.
If Rose Brooks Center didn't exist, okay, I can't even imagine. I can't imagine what they would do. I think there would be more lives that would be ended because of it. I truly do.
Project Safe is not like an ordinary, you meet an appointment with a counselor. You get to talk to your counselor, but like a friend.
Whenever you have someone that shows that they care, then
you feel like you have purpose.
It's just a great program to be in, and anyone, any teen that's going through this or any other situation should definitely be in this because it helps out tremendously.
It's like having someone that actually cares without pretending to and doesn't have to.
They've helped my children feel okay about what they were, you know, going through, that it wasn't the end of the world, that they could be successful and happy, and it's all, you know, transpired. Everything that they worked towards has happened.
She deserves this. She's been through a lot, and she deserves to have her own home and just to be able to just feel good about something, to own something. She's something else.
To be proud and be able to accomplish something like this.
Staff and everyone at Rosebrooks will be a permanent family for me. They've taught me how to dream and plan and survive and succeed. You know, well, actually refresh those things that I had and lost. They gave them back to me.